entrance hymn, I will turn my steps. I'll turn my steps to the altar of gold. I'll turn my steps to the gladness of my life. I'll turn my steps to the altar of gold. I'll turn my steps to the gladness of my life. Fill my heart with your truth and your light. As I enter with joy in your sight, I'll turn my steps to the altar of gold. I'll turn my steps to the gladness of my life.
My dear devotees of Saint Anthony, offer this sacrifice and this novena in honor of Saint Anthony for your intentions. Whatever intention you have, you can offer it now. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, today we pray for the suffering people. Those are in a hospital, old age home, that they may look at cross, as Jesus offered his suffering for our redemption, that they may offer their suffering for the well-being of others. But many times we fail to pray for the suffering people. For this we ask God's forgiveness and pardon. Lord Jesus, many times we fail to meditate on your suffering, death and resurrection. For this we ask your pardon. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, many a time we fail to pray for suffering people. For this we ask your pardon. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, many a time we fail to offer our suffering for the well-being of others, especially for our family members. For this we ask your pardon. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Almighty God, have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Let us pray. May the martyr Saint Boniface be our advocate, O Lord, that we may firmly hold the faith he taught with his lips and sealed in his blood, and confidently profess it by our deeds. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
The first reading, a reading from the second letter of St. Paul to Timothy. You have observed my teaching, my conduct, my aim in life, my faith, my patience, my love, my steadfastness, my persecutions, my sufferings. All what befell me at Antioch, at Iconium, and at Lystra, the persecutions I endured. Yet from them all, Lord rescued me. Indeed, all who desire to live a godly life in Christ will go on and will be persecuted, while evil men and impostors will go from bad to worse, deceivers and deceived. But as for you, continue in what you have learned and have firmly believed, knowing from whom you've learnt it, and how from childhood you have been acquainted with the sacred writings which you have been acquainted with, which are able to instruct you for salvation in faith through Christ. All scripture is inspired by God and profitable for teaching, for reproof, for correction, and for training in righteousness, that man of God may be complete and equipped for every good work. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Your response shall be, the lovers of your law have great peace. Please repeat.
The lovers of your law have great peace.
Though my foes and oppressors are countless, I have not swerved from your will. Your word is founded on truth. Your decrees are eternal. Your response?
The lovers of your law have great peace.
Though princes oppress me without cause, I stand in awe of your word. The lovers of your law have great peace. They never stumble. Your response?
The lovers of your law have great peace.
I await your saving help, O Lord. I fulfill your commands. I obey your precepts and your will. All that I do is before you. Your response?
The lovers of your law have great peace.
Please rise for the gospel acclamation.
Hallelujah!
Hallelujah! Hallelujah!
Bend my heart to your will, O Lord, and teach me your law.
Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Hallelujah!
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Mark.
Glory be to you, O Lord.
At that time, as Jesus taught in the temple, he said, "How can the scribes say that the Christ is the son of David? David himself in the Holy Spirit declared, 'The Lord said to my Lord, sit at my right hand until I put your enemies under your feet.' David himself calls him Lord. So how is he his son?" And the great throng heard him gladly. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise be to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Scripture are inspired by God. My dear brothers and sisters, how did God inspire the scripture? Many times people ponder, meditate over it. Some suggest that God dictated to biblical writers as a boss dictates to a private secretary. Others suggest the biblical writers were inspired religiously, as songwriters are inspired musically. Most people hold a middle position. They hold that God enlightened the writers in such a way that they wrote all and only what God wanted them to write. God is therefore the primary author. The biblical writers are secondary authors. The important thing, however, is not how the biblical writers were inspired, but that they were. One of the counseling seminar I attended, and one of the professors told us, Bible is the best counseling book in the world. It has helped millions of people. It will help because lots of wisdom and counseling skills are in a Bible. Samuel Taylor Coleridge said, The words of the Bible find me at a deeper level of my being than any other book does. Daniel Webster said, "My heart has always assured me that the gospel of Jesus Christ must be divine reality." And that's what we see in the lives of saints. Saint Anthony was so much inspired by the scripture. And he was meditating. We see in his statue, in his hand, there's a Bible, and baby Jesus is holding it now. One with the Bible, one with the scripture. And he experienced baby Jesus in his arm. That's what I say in today's first reading stage. Scripture is inspired by God. Today's gospel, Jesus making the point that the Messiah is not just David's son. The Messiah is also the Lord. David uses to refer to the Messiah is Lord. Today is a memorial of Saint Boniface. He was a bishop and martyr. He was born in England about the year 673. He became a monk in the monastery. And in 1790, he went to Germany to preach the faith. He had great success and was consecrated Bishop of Mainz. And with the help of his companion, he founded, rather restored the diocese of Bavaria, Thuringia, and Franconia. He presided over a number of councils and promulgated laws. While he was engaged in the evangelization of Friesland, he was killed by the pagans in the year 754, and his body was buried in the monastery of Fulda. During this Mass, we remember all those who are celebrating their birthdays and anniversaries today, that the Lord may bless them abundantly. All those whose name is Boniface, their feast today, that the Lord may bless them and Boniface intercede for them. We also remember the suffering people, people who are in hospital, old age home, those are suffering because of coronavirus, those are affected by a cyclone, that the Lord may be with them. The suffering people may look up at cross, as Jesus take up the cross for our redemption, similar way they take up their suffering for the well-being of others. For these intentions and all our personal intentions, we offer this sacrifice. Amen.
For the offertory, we take the hymn On the Pattern. On the pattern with the host, I offer up my lowly heart. All my life, my deeds, my thoughts, thine shall be as mine thou art. In the chalice let me be a drop of water mingled there. Lost, O Jesus, in thy love, thy great sacrifice I share.
Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Trusting in your compassion, O Lord, we come eagerly with our offerings to your sacred altar, that through the purifying action of your grace, we may be cleansed by the very mysteries we serve, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let's give thanks to the Lord. our God,
it is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for the blood of your blessed martyrs and Boniface, poured out like Christ to glorify your name, shows forth your marvelous works, by which in our weakness you perfect your power, and on the feeble bestow strength to bear you witness through Christ our Lord. And so with the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty, without end, we acclaim,
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed, O holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and the working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to his setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread. He gave you thanks and praise. He gave to his disciples and saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that you may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostle and glorious martyr, Saint Boniface, and with all the saints, Saint Anthony of Padua, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, Thomas, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, especially our dear and near ones who are not with us, for whom we want to offer this sacrifice, and to all who are pleasing to you, at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom, that we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestowed on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostle, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
As God's one family, let's offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Act of Spiritual Communion.
My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament.
I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot receive you sacramentally now, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us pray. Governed by your Spirit, we pray, O Lord. Those you feed with the body and blood of your Son, the professing you not just in word or in speech, but also in works and in truth, we may merit to enter the kingdom of heaven through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Novena prayer to Saint Anthony.
Of sanctity. O glorious Saint Anthony, who didst enjoy the sweet privilege of receiving into thy arms the infant Jesus, I beseech thee to take me under thy powerful protection. Thou in whom the power of working miracles shines forth among the other gifts of God, have pity upon me and come to my aid in this my great need.
We make our petitions. Cleanse my heart from every disorderly affliction.
Obtain for me a true contrition for my sins, and a great love of God and of my neighbor, that serving God faithfully in this life, I may come to praise, enjoy, and bless Him eternally with Thee in paradise. Amen.
Pray for us, Saint Anthony,
that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ.
Let us pray. Most merciful Jesus, who has glorified in an admirable manner Thy holy confessor, Saint Anthony, by continued miracles, give us thy grace to feel assured that we shall obtain through his intercession and merits what we ask in confidence, who lives and reigns with God the Father and the Holy Spirit forever and ever. Amen. Turn to page number 3. Litany of Saint Anthony. Lord, have mercy on us.
Lord, have mercy on us.
Christ, have mercy on us.
Christ, have mercy on us.
Lord, have mercy on us.
Lord, have mercy on us.
Christ, hear us.
Christ, graciously hear us.
God, the Father of heaven,
have mercy on us.
God, the Son, Redeemer of the world,
have mercy on us.
God, the Holy Spirit,
have mercy on us.
Holy Trinity, one God,
have mercy on us.
Our response is, pray for us. Holy Mary, conceived without sin,
pray for us.
Saint Anthony of Padua,
pray for us.
Saint Anthony, glory of Fire Minor,
pray for us.
Saint Anthony, lily of virginity,
pray for us.
Saint Anthony, gem of poverty,
pray for us.
Saint Anthony, example of obedience,
pray for us.
Saint Anthony, mirror of abstinence,
pray for us.
St. Anthony, vessel of purity,
pray for us.
St. Anthony, star of sanctity,
pray for us.
St. Anthony, model of conduct,
pray for us.
St. Anthony, beauty of paradise,
pray for us.
St. Anthony, ark of the testament,
pray for us.
St. Anthony, keeper of the scriptures,
pray for us.
St. Anthony, teacher of the truth,
pray for us.
St. Anthony, preacher of the grace,
pray for us.
St. Anthony, exterminator of vices,
pray for us.
St. Anthony, planter of virtues,
pray for us.
St. Anthony, conqueror of heretics,
pray for us.
St. Anthony, terror of infidels,
pray for us.
St. Anthony, consoler of the afflicted,
pray for us.
St. Anthony, guardian of the conscience,
pray for us.
St. Anthony, martyr in desire,
pray for us.
St. Anthony, terror of the devils,
pray for us.
St. Anthony, performer of miracles,
pray for us.
St. Anthony, finder of lost things,
pray for us.
St. Anthony, helper of all who invoke you,
pray for us.
Be merciful.
Spare us, O Lord.
Be merciful.
Hear us, O Lord.
From all evil,
deliver us, Lord.
From all sin,
deliver us, Lord.
From the snares of the devil,
deliver us, Lord.
From pestilence, famine, and war,
deliver us, Lord.
From eternal death,
deliver us, Lord.
Through the merits of St. Anthony,
deliver us, Lord.
Through his ardent charity,
deliver us, Lord.
Through his zealous preaching,
deliver us, Lord.
Through his desire of martyrdom,
deliver us, Lord.
Through his strict observance of obedience, poverty, and chastity,
deliver us, Lord.
On the day of judgment,
deliver us, Lord.
Our responses, we beseech you, hear us. We sinners,
we beseech you, hear us.
That you accept to lead us to true penance,
we beseech you, hear us.
That you accept and inflame us with divine love,
we beseech you, hear us.
That you accept to let us ever enjoy the protection of St. Anthony,
we beseech you, hear us.
That you accept to give us, by merits of St. Anthony, the gift of true contrition, humility, and contemplation,
we beseech you, hear us.
That you accept us the grace, through the intercession of St. Anthony, to overcome the world, the flesh, and the devil,
we beseech you, hear us.
That you accept the assistance of St. Anthony to all who invoke him in their necessities,
we beseech you, hear us.
That you accept graciously to hear us,
we beseech you, hear us.
Son of God,
we beseech you, hear us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world,
spare us, O Lord.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world,
hear us, O Lord.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world,
have mercy on us.
Christ, hear us.
Christ, graciously hear us.
Pray for us, O Blessed Anthony,
that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ.
Let us pray. Almighty and eternal God, who did glorify your faithful confessor Anthony with the perpetual gift of working miracles, graciously grant that what we confidently seek through his merits, we may surely receive through his intercession, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Act of consecration. O glorious Saint Anthony,
servant and friend of God, I offer myself through you to the most loving heart of our divine Savior, Jesus Christ, whom you did bear in your pure arms under the form of a child. I choose you today as my patron, advocate, and friend. I place all my cares and temptations in your hands. I earnestly resolve never to forsake you.
Great Saint, Lily of celestial purity, obtain for me and all the faithful perfect purity of God and soul. I also, in imitation of your zeal, promise to lead others to the knowledge, the love, and the service of God through my own life. Amen. Turn page number 20. Page number 26th day. Consideration. The poverty of St. Anthony. Let us consider how our saint, impelled by the love of evangelical poverty, abandoned his rich inheritance, despised earthly goods, refuse with a holy indignation the magnificent presence which Asclepius sent him, by driving from his presence the messenger of that tyrant, saying, "Go, tell your master that I shall not share with him the spoils of the poor." In view of this disinterestedness, let us take the firm resolution to detach ourselves from riches, which are the source of so many evils. If we possess them, let us resolve that our hearts will not be attached to them. If we are poor, that we may not desire riches, because at the hour of death, we will have to leave all things behind. Prayer.
O loving Jesus,
source of all good, real good,
who did become man and did vouchsafe to embrace poverty, to teach us to despise the things of the world, grant us by your love, Saint Anthony, the grace to be his imitators in detachment from everything which can estrange us from you, and to despise earthly riches in order to merit the riches of heaven for all eternity. Amen.
Prayer for protection against coronavirus. O God, in this time of the coronavirus, we turn to you in trust and hope. You are ever full of mercy, compassion, and love towards us. We ask you, loving Father, to be merciful to us, and in your divine power, take away from all over the world this grievous pandemic of coronavirus. Inspire all authorities to take effective measures to contain the disease. Help us to be alert and vigilant against coronavirus, and to follow all guidelines and directives. You redeemed and saved us through the suffering and resurrection of Jesus. Help us not to be discouraged, but to believe and hope that you will bring good out of this evil. Father, let your victory and glory shine through this deadly disease, through Christ our Lord. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
My dear devotees of St. Anthony, see you tomorrow, 12 noon, for the seventh day of Novena Mass and Novena Prayer in honor of St. Anthony. God bless you, and St. Anthony may intercede for us.
For the recessional, we shall sing, "I'll Say Yes." I'll say yes, yes, yes. I'll say yes, yes, yes. I'll say yes, Lord. I'll say yes, Lord. I'll say yes, yes, yes. Where you lead me, I will follow. Where you lead me, I will follow. Where you lead me, I will follow. I'll go with you, yes, with you, all the way. I'll say yes, yes, yes. I'll say yes, yes, yes. I'll say yes, Lord. I'll say yes, Lord. I'll say yes, yes, yes.